witnessing tonight is the result of implicit unity of purpose, which I am proud of.
I can see it, then I can do it. If I just believe it, then First and foremost, I'd like to congratulate the ministry. I'd like to congratulate the Minister of State, and he's. I know the ministry, in conjunction with the Minister of Transportation, they've worked very hard to get to this point, and now it's not done. We're here. It's been unveiled. We know the new name for the airline. We know we're getting 5 jets come December.
For the government of Nigeria, it's extremely important that this service is provided. Reason being, it is a service that is needed, and also it will offer employment opportunities, it will kickstart and ginger up and double up and rush the growth of the economy of Nigeria. So we take it as extremely very important venture, and that is why government thought it has a responsibility upon itself, both moral and social, to try to create a new national carrier that will be typically and basically and indeed in letters and spirit private sector led and driven through a PPP arrangement. And because Nigeria, under the leadership of His Excellency President Muhammadu Buhari, who always queried in his campaign movements that we used to have Nigeria Airways and it's no more, why is the airline and why is the money? He had asked this question severally. In that quest, before he even made me minister, he had a committee to look into possibility of bringing back a robust national carrier, which we inherited in that committee and its report. And before it, there are many reports regarding establishment of national carrier. Okay. What is different today is that it's going to be a PPP model. And by the laws of Nigeria, by the Act of Parliament, there's an entity called the ICRC, the Infrastructure Concession Regulatory Commission, saddled with the powers to regulate and oversee PPP arrangements.
Hello, this is Events, the show with a difference. The city that is set upon the hill that cannot be hidden. The Rolls Royce of all entertainment of shows and television events. We are the Farnborough Air Show 2018. To witness the launch or the unveiling of the Nigerian carrier, Nigerian Air. The unveiling was done by Senator Adi Siraka, the Honorable Minister of State for Aviation. And this was what he had to say.
Future of aviation is growth, development. It, we're seeing the start of it now. And this airline is going to be private sector led and driven with no government participation in its management or control. And the investors into this airline would be the ones to decide who manages it anyway, because that's their funds, that's their money, that's their wealth.
Yeah, but we've seen two private airlines, Arab Airline and Medu Airline recently, and they came into London and, and folded up recently, sir.
Well, I wouldn't know what are the reasons, but I'm sure that there's issue of governance in that place. And airline business shouldn't be a one-man show. One man can run an airline, yes, but he has to have the discipline to allow professionals to run it. And he should have no interference in it. And he should allow it to run to provide the service. Yes. Because if you are doing an airline service,
yes, sir,
you are in a contract with people to and goods to move them from point A to B. Any delay, any cancellation, you're actually breaching a contract.
It's a private-public partnership, so even though the government is very initiative of starting this new airline called Nigeria Air, we launched it today with this wonderful new logo, the government is not going to run it. It is not a government airline. It will be a private-public partnership. We have several interests. My team's job will be in the next half year to find the right investor, the right partner to run and manage Nigeria Air.
The minister also took time out after the unveiling to speak with potential investors, explaining to them the rationale behind the new Nigerian airline. He explained that it was for economic reasons, to create jobs and to boost Nigerian economy. The event was well attended. We had people from all walks of life, captains of industries, investors, airline operators, bankers, politicians, aspirants, and so on. Also in attendance was the first Nigerian Airways pilot, Captain Ace.
I believe the future is bright. From what the minister just, from the minister's speech earlier on today, he's actually confirmed that this is going to be a PPP managed airline. So we're quite confident that the management will be superb. The planes that are being purchased are actually superb. It's going to be the best in West Africa and probably in the whole of Africa. So we're quite happy that the APC again has actually delivered as promised that before the end of this first term, that the Nigeria airline will actually be revived. That's been done. We've actually started today. It's a step in the right direction. And hopefully, like the minister said, by December 2018, which I believe is on the 19th or 20th of December, we shall be launching the airline with five brand new super jets. So we thank the Buhari-led administration for that.
I think it's very exciting, very promising. I'm conscious of the fact that we've walked this path before, but I think with the commitment of the minister and his team, I think it's a very bright future.
The thing is that it's going to benefit, this new airline is going to benefit those of us in the diaspora, especially the business-minded entrepreneurs. Yeah. I think there's going to be a special package people to get involved with the PPP system that's going to operate the airline. So yeah, good news for you guys in the diaspora.
Okay.